Rise from your grave.
Greetings, friends, Steven, and welcome to Gamer Hall, episode 44. This is my very own video games and more pickup series. Today's recording date is Sunday, August 23rd, 2015. So, today's backdrop item are some really small but kind of addictive tiny Minecraft figures. As you can see, I mean, look, like, it's the size of my thumb, basically. It's a tiny ocelot. But I don't know, these things are kind of cool. Get your Zambi. Get the silverfish. I don't think I've even seen these in the game yet, but there you go. We've got this more recent series, which has a zombie on fire, as well as, I don't even know which character this is. I've been calling her Girl Steve because the main guy's supposedly named Steve, although they don't know for certain. This is the third series now, the Netherrack series, and here. Now, here is the three-pack back of these, three of the ones I just showed. Got that set there. Yeah, no, I've just been in a Minecraft mood lately, and these are actually kind of expensive. They're like $4 per tiny figure. But, you know, sometimes you're just bored and you want to buy a blind box of some sort, and yeah, these are kind of cool. So, this is our start of our show here. Now, about a week ago, I decided to take a trip to the mainland, and I bought a whole bunch of stuff. So, that is basically what our Gamer Hall is going to be all about. So, let's take a look at... Oh, man. Okay, I'm also going to splice in some pictures I took throughout the day because, yeah, why not? So the first stop I went to was actually a Toys R Us, and I wasn't expecting to find anything special at all, but wouldn't you know it, I wander over to the Amiibo section, and of all the, like, there's a store in Richmond that sells Amiibo, like, that they ported in from Japan for like $50 or something. I just waltz into the Toys R Us, and look what I found. In fact, here, just check out this picture. Actually, I'll show the picture after I show these two. But starting off, we have Ike, the very rare Super Smash Brothers Amiibo. He's, of course, from the Fire Emblem series. I didn't think I wanted an Ike Amiibo, but it was just kind of the shock of seeing one. These are like, what, $15, if not more, each now? So, I guess I bought it for the collection and just the shock of seeing one. This is actually the first time I've even seen an Ike Amiibo for sale. They've always disappeared beyond that. Like, I actually had one of these pre-ordered, but the pre-order sold out before I could even pick my own up. And they also, surprisingly, had a Marth. I haven't seen a Marth Amiibo since day one, when the Amiibo first came out. I remember not wanting to buy a Marth just because there were so many others to pick from, and I didn't think there'd be any kind of shortages like there have been lately. But, I mean, yeah, it's pretty cool. The swords are... They're not, like, bent, as they often are, depending on just the specific figures. But, yeah, these are pretty neat. Here, let me just drop this picture in real quick for you. Okay, so as you can see, this wasn't the only Ike. They had a second one. I could have bought two. I didn't, because, I mean, that's... We don't need any more resellers in this world. And did you see all those villagers? Like, what? I couldn't believe it. I figured they would have been sold out. Like, I just wandered in and found these. Not that I'm complaining, though. It's very cool. So let me just put these in the corner. There we go. My camera's a bit off-center. Nah, it's fine. Alright. If I just put this here. Yeah. Then. Okay. So, I moved on from there, that was a Toys R Us, and where did I end up next? Okay, so there was a collectibles store that had, like, cards and toys and games and all that, and they're actually having a moving sale. So, a bunch of neat stuff, nothing I really wanted. Check out this next picture. Okay, so that was a call from Alien Resurrection, the action figure. I almost bought that. I think it was like $15 or something. I was like, it's kind of cool. I don't know. She looked a bit mannish. But I did buy a couple of my beloved blind boxes. As you can see, I'm in a blind box mood. These days, more so than ever, which is strange because you obviously you don't know which one you're getting. I picked up a couple of these Game of Thrones vinyl figures. This is the Edition 1. I've got most of Edition 2, but I've only got a handful of Edition 1s. Now, as you can see, I've opened these already. So, we have a White Walker. I believe this one might glow in the dark. It's hard to tell. Either the 2 and the 24 or the 1 and 72. Yeah, I don't know, I'll have to try it out, see if he glows or not. Regardless, pretty neat figure. And in the other box, we got the man who knows nothing. It is Jon Snow. Pretty neat figure. I didn't have either one of these in the series yet. Since they're easily accessible off camera, I can actually bring out the other three I do have on this edition one. Got Ned Stark and King of the North, and that was my neighbor being noisy outside, because that's what neighbors love to do. And Arya, of course. They're pretty neat figures. That was actually all I bought at that store. There was, not a lot of time to get from place to place, so you pick up what looks best and you move on. This was just a day trip, so I had to get out pretty quick. Drink some iced tea. It's still summertime and it's still hot out. Alright. Let me put these back. Yeah, pretty good random gets, as some might put it. Put the other ones off camera because they don't really count. Alright. So the next place I went to is actually... Well, I went to several places, but the next place I bought something from was the place that I just mentioned that sells a bunch of overpriced amiibo. Here's a picture. Here's some sort of pictures. We got something, a picture of their wall. It's just loaded with stuff. Check this out. Okay. And here, they actually had Yarn Yoshis imported from Japan. They're smaller than I thought, but here, check it out. Alrighty. Now, the one thing I was hoping to find there was these, there's like these Mega Man, you know the Gashpons? I was thinking you put like a buck or two and then you turn the thing and then a little random toy pops out. There's a Mega Man series that came out in Japan, and they did have those, but they were selling them for $10 each, and that's a bit much. But what I did get, I got one of these for $4, which is also a bit much if you ask me. But, you know, I was there for the day, I had to get something. It's already slightly partly open, but not really. It is a Mario sound drop. Once again, a random... You don't know which one you're getting until you get it. I wonder if Dean from Round 2 Gaming has all of these by now. Probably. So as you can see, you got one that does... I would have liked this start one that just plays the Mario song. You got jumping, becoming big, getting a coin, getting one up. Going down a pipe, swimming, and dying. So, it's like a little keychain. What you do is just pull this little tab out here. And then, if I push this, that's all it does. It's pretty neat, I guess. There you go. And yeah, like I said, $4, a bit much. Normally these things are like $2 or something, or 200 yen. But I guess they want to get their markup and get their profits up and all that, yada, yada, yada. So I bought just one. I figured one would be enough. And yeah, jumping Mario, kind of cool. Alright. Let's see. Is that about it? I stopped by some arcades. I can just drop in a couple, couple of the cooler arcade machines here. So check this out real quick. Okay. excuse me. I think that's about all I got. This was in Richmond. So then we moved on to... Oh, I checked out a flea market. This is going to be pretty good. I found a like a flea market, and they were selling a bunch of old LCD games. And as you guys know, I do quite enjoy the LCD games. So, first one to show off is the Talking Play. What does that say? Play-by-play? Talking Play-by-play Baseball. This is a two-player LCD game. Like, look how small the screen is. But everything else is just huge. It's awesome. It's got the sound and what might even be like a headphone jack. No, check this out. Made in Hong Kong, English unit inside. It does have batteries in it. Brought to us by Video Technology 1986. Yeah, this is a bit loud, but check it out.
Top of the first inning. Eagles at bat. Missed strike one.
And there you go. Batteries were included. Pretty neat thing. I guess I wouldn't recommend unless you like collecting the real vintage stuff. But, I mean, goddamn. Look, it's pretty big. It's got its own D-pad. And yeah, pretty neat. They also had... Just filling with this bag off camera here. Excuse me. The next one, Volcano by Radio Shack. And I haven't even tried this one out yet. But batteries are included once again. As you can see, it's just been running. This whole time, like I got these a week ago, but the batteries last a pretty good amount of time. Cool. This one actually even came with the instruction book, which is pretty neat. Don't know if there's really much to say, but yeah. Pretty cool. And the last LCD, oops. Last LCD I picked up from the store was a Tetris Junior. This I actually played a bit when I was waiting for the ferry. Yeah, it works pretty well. You can see it there. I won't go into details, but you know, it's Tetris. Cute little LCD form. Brought to us by Hero 1996, the Tetris company. Tetris Junior. Pretty cool. And in the same store as well. Well, store is like a more like a little booth. They also had a bunch of these things, which are really neat. Japan had these for sale for a little while, I guess in 2006. What you do is you put this back onto this base, and then you can pull these out and put them back in wherever you want, and it's like a little display, and each one has a button, and it makes noise. Pretty neat. Now. Actually, got a few of those, and here's the wrapper that came with that one. Here's another one for Galaxian, but as you can see here, my lighting just got weird. The space aliens are actually a different color than those ones, which are all red with blue wings. This one is a blue, and a purple one, so I don't know what the difference is. I won't open these ones. Well, I won't open this one because you can see it's going to be exactly the same. Same noise. This one is different though. Here we have the title of them, the Namco dot graph figure with sound. This looks to be Rally X, so I might as well crack this open. In fact, I'll just put a quick edit point here just to save time. So wrapped now, but no, it's unwrapped. This, like I said, I won't put it together, you just saw, you get the gist of it. We got the pieces there, it's just the two cars, so I guess you get more pieces out of the Galaxian one. And I believe the battery was dying on this one, so... So that's just spooky. New Rally X. I guess I'll replace the battery on that. I will open this up though because I want to see. I want to see all the ones that come with these Namco sets. Oh, Tower of Juhaga, that'd be pretty neat. So we got your Mappy, your Zebius, New Rally X, Dig Dug, Galaxian, and Tower of Juhaga. That's pretty cool. And you can see there's a couple of variant ones. Oops, just dropped my paper. Upside down, and right side up. So I guess that's one of the variants they have of Galaxian there. Yeah, just neat little collectible doodads from Japan. And I'm just whipping around. All right. Let's see. Got a whole bunch of. Okay. So now we're getting into more traditional game pickups. Let me just set these up. So, most systems that I like to collect for, like, you know, NES, Super Nintendo, all that sort of thing, they're getting really expensive, but the one system I find that's still pretty reasonable is original Game Boy, which is awesome because I do like to collect original Game Boy games. So, what did I find? This. Just getting them right off camera. Not that. Okay. So once again at the flea market, I picked up a whole three Game Boy games, and we're going to start this off with Robin Hood, Prince of Thieves, Virgin Games. Put to us by Encore Video Games. I've actually heard good things about this Prince of Thieves game. I haven't tried it yet. This is of course a port, I believe, of the NES game. Might be its own thing, I'm not sure, I haven't tried it yet. These I got, I think... It was about 20 bucks or so for three of these. Next up, Maui Mallard in Cold Shadow with Super Game Boy compatibility. This I didn't know existed. I know of the game for Super Nintendo, but I had no clue that there was a Game Boy port, so that's pretty funny. Had to pick that up. First time I've ever even seen it. Apparently, it's been put together by Sunsoft, too. So that's pretty cool. And the last I picked up from this specific location was brought to us by Acclaim. It is Dragonheart. Did you know that Dragonheart had a Game Boy game? I sure didn't. 1996. And yeah. You've seen my pickups in these videos, like, you know, if it's a weird game that I didn't know even existed, those are the games I like to pick up nowadays. Not the well-known games that are always overpriced. Let's see. Actually, we're almost done. From there, we did a few more stops. We might. No, we're gonna go to New West now. There's a store, Game Deals, Video Games. I picked up some more Game Boy games. I've been keen to check out the store again. We've got several retro gaming shops in Victoria. It's fun to see what the other shops are like around in BC. This place, kind of cramped, kind of dark, but I found some interesting, very random Game Boy games. Like, has anyone ever heard of this? Brain Bender? Like, Electro Brain? What? Look at this cover. How would you not want to buy this? $5. I don't know, man. I actually took next week off from work, so who knows, I might actually put up some new Should I Keep It's, and as you can see, we've got plenty to try out. Next up, we have Rampart by Jalico. This one's actually a bit beat up, as you can see the sticker there. A bit picked at, but Rampart's a great game. Back's a bit gross, so I don't know. I might not even keep this, just because of the condition it's in. I guess you could say I could replace it with a better copy if I find one. Next up, another completely random game that I probably never heard of until now. It is Laszlo's Leap for a whole $2. I'm guessing it tries to do some sort of weird 3D effect. I don't know. Would make a fun video though, nonetheless. Next up, I don't think I've ever even tried these... This is the original Star Trek 23rd or 25th? Whatever, 25th anniversary, brought to us by Ultra Games, aka Konami, $6.95. I think I got a bit of a deal on these. Yeah, I've never tried this one. I think it's, it might be decent. I don't know for certain. And the last game I picked up from them, Nobunaga's Ambition, $6.95 by Koei. This is one of those heavy early Koei like strategy games, and just neat to find it on the original Game Boy. I doubt I'd ever played this for any real amount of time, but you know, need a little cart, fun collectible, cool art. So before I left that store, I was buying those games. I was like, okay, that's fine, good to go. And they actually had some Japanese games right by the till. So I'm like, hey, can I check those games out? And they're like, yeah, they're super cheap because we don't know what they are. And we just have them. I want to get rid of them. So I'm like, well, all right then. So I picked up some more games for them. So I made a second purchase. Starting with Nemesis, a.k.a. Gradius. This is, of course, the Japanese version. Or is it? Maybe it's the local version. I don't know. It's in great condition nonetheless. A classic shoot 'em up, horizontal based. Definitely worth checking out if you have not yet. Cool cover art. Just give me 1 second. I'll be right back. Okay, we're back. I just wanted to clean up the table here a bit. I've got my phone out here. I'm just checking to see what pictures I got. If there's anything I want to mention. I might sneak in a few more pictures here. There's a mall in Richmond, the one where I picked up some of that stuff that I mentioned. They actually had this neat little, like, early mammals display. They had these animatronics here. Just for fun, I might as well drop those in. I took a few pictures. Just check these out. I think they're pretty neat. Okay. It's just a weird thing to see in a mall. But I thought they were pretty cool. I had to check those out. What else we got? So now we're pretty much caught up. So we've got a few more Game Boy games to show. I just showed that one off. Now these are the ones that they had in the weird Japanese section that they just didn't know what to do with. Next up, by Pony Canyon. I don't know what that's trying to say, but I'm thinking this is Boxel. You know those games where you like just push boxes into spots, but you can't pull them, and all you can do is push them? I'm thinking that's what this is. One of those games. Can't remember they're called. Sokoban or something like that. I've actually got such a game on my phone here. Sokoban. So I'm thinking this is Sokoban 2 by Pony Canyon, 1990. These are in really nice shape too. Like, these domestic ones are actually in some ways a bit more beat up. Go figure. But they say the Japanese are really good with their games for the most part. Next up, a game I couldn't even imagine what it is, but I had to buy it considering this cover art. oh my goodness. Towa Chiki. It looks like some sort of fish-eating fish game. I don't know what's happening in this, but I had to pick it up. These were, like I said, these were, like, once again, like $5, if even that. $5 each, so I had to pick these up. And they even had a few Japanese Game Boy Color games. This one I was happy to find because I've been wanting to get a copy of Street Fighter Alpha on the Game Boy Color, but the cards are usually kind of expensive. This one was pretty reasonable, so here it is, Street Fighter Alpha. Really fluid animation. It's surprising how good of a job they did on this considering it's a Game Boy Color game. And finally, last Game Boy game I picked up. I don't know if this is a port or a brand new adventure. It is, excuse me, one of the Goemon games or Mystical Ninja. Game Boy Color, Konami, 1986 to 2000. So I don't know. It might be like a remaster of some older game, or it could be a brand new adventure. I'm not sure, but we'll give it a shot sooner or later. And yeah, pretty neat little addition to the collection. So the video is pretty much over. Just have one last bit of things to show here. I went to the comic store in downtown Vancouver. Some neat stuff, but the thing I wanted the most there were these Mega Man mini-series Kid Robot blind boxes. Once again, sticking with the blind box theme. Now, the neat thing about these is that they actually, at this store, they actually opened up the more expensive ones to find out which ones are in there, so you don't just pick up the ones you maybe want and you don't necessarily want, because like I said, $13.99, that's a bit of an expensive blind box. But as you can see here, Leckman, he's got a little sticker on his face because that's what was in this one. So this one I've already opened. Quite honestly, as much as I love Mega Man, I'm not too keen on these specific Kid Robot figures. I don't know, doesn't look quite right. It's kind of cool. It brings to mind the Titans line, but maybe not quite as good. So I got a Luckman there, and then we got two more. So I'm just gonna crack these open right quick. They've just been retaped on the bottom, so I'm just gonna have to make a little incision with a trusty pocket knife. So next one I got was Bomb Man. This before I noticed, that's actually I like this one more. I think maybe it's just the colors. Like this one, I don't know. The colors just look faded, kind of weak. I think Bomb Man looks better. And I dig this smirk on his face. It's pretty cool. Okay, like I said before I noticed that they actually did that thing with the stickers on the sides, I was actually gonna just pick this one up randomly, and I would have been pretty happy with. It's funny because if I didn't know that they had these listed as which one was in each box, I probably would have only purchased one, and this would have been it. But they actually showed them, showed what was in them. And as you can see here, it actually comes with a bomb. So, you can stick that in his hand there. Now it's holding a bomb. That's fun. Okie dokie. Oops. Just make sure you can actually see them there. I still need to sort out a better recording spot for these. It's always cramped when I shoot these, unfortunately. And the final one that I picked out of. Yes. Guts, man. Some paint defects. He got a little line there. Some schwitz on his chin. Yeah, this one's okay. I don't know. Do you see the paint there on his head? Looks a bit faded. Doesn't even look like paint. It looks like that's just the color that they made the plastic. I don't know. They're okay. Maybe not worth $13.99. But yeah. So there you go. I guess that about does it for our latest Gamer Hall episode here. So everyone, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this latest episode. Like I said, I took all of next week off, so hopefully I might be able to get some more videos out. I would like to do more Should I Keep It? I mean, like, every time I shoot one of these, there's always a new wacky collection of games that I'm keen to try out. And yeah, so there you go. Everyone, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.